الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, all praise is due to Allah, and may the best of peace and blessings be to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and household and companions and followers on the righteous path until the day of judgment. And we are living with the real stars, the friends of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And today we will look at another companion, one of those stars, Abu Talha al-Ansari. Abu Talha al-Ansari. Abu Talha is from al-Ansar, and he has few stories that we need to stop at and look at and take examples from. Abu Talha radiallahu anhu was one of the 12 nuqaba, or 12 representatives of Ansar, to meet with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and invite him to al-Madinah. Before he accepts Islam, he has a wonderful story of his marriage of Ummu Sulaym. Ummu Sulaym, the mother of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, so he was the stepfather of Anas ibn Malik. She had a wonderful story with him because he proposed for her, and she apologized. And he said, I know why you don't want to get married to me. It's because you want somebody who is more rich. You want gold and silver. She said, by Allah, this is not my goal. And if you were a Muslim, the only thing is Islam. You are mushrik, you are a polytheist, and I cannot get married as a Muslima. I cannot get married to a polytheist. And in order for me to prove that to you, I'm telling you, if you become Muslim, I'm going to get married to you. And he was thinking of his so-called God, idol, that he is taken from wood. She started talking to him nicely and presenting Islam to him. Subhanallah, is all what it takes or what it needs from us is to present Islam with hikmah, in the nicest way, in the right way, in the right time. She presented Islam to him and she said, yeah, Abu Talha, you are a smart person. You take a god, you think your god is that piece of the trunk of the tree that grew from the earth? This piece, this part of the same trunk of a tree that maybe another part of the same trunk could, someone else could have burned it, use it as wood to burn. Now you're taking another part and calling it god. Do you really think this is god? She started talking to him until he decided to accept Islam, and he accepted Islam and she got married to him. And Sahaba later on, they used to say, we do not know of any dowry that is more noble than the dowry of Ummu Sulaym, because her dowry was Islam. She did not take anything or ask for anything for her dowry other than the Islam, or her husband accepting Islam, future husband to accept Islam for him to be her husband, Abu Sulaym. They got married and they lived together, alhamdulillah, and they set a good example of a Muslim family. The father is there, or the husband is there, and the wife is there. Until one other incident that we have to stop by, this beautiful, subhanallah, strong faith believer, strong believer in Islam, Ummu Sulaym radiallahu anha, they have a baby together. And then Abu Sulaym was outside for something, traveling, and the baby passed away. When Abu Sulaym radiallahu anhu came back, and he used to love this baby so much, she did not want to just give him the news about the death of his baby. She decided to, you know, take it to him step by step. First of all, she prepared the food for him, and she waited until he got his dinner, and she even beautified herself so she will have what a wife would have with her husband. They had a nice night together, and they had the intimacy together, and then she told him, and he was mad. She told him afterwards, and she told him in the nicest way. She said, what do you think if somebody borrowed something from you, and then it was time for him to get back whatever he has lent you or given you? Would you give it to him? He said, yes, that's, you know, this is something that's being borrowed and it has to be given back. He said, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken back what he has given to you, or as a ariya, or just as a temporary gift for you. He has claimed it back. Your son has passed away. he was so mad, and he said, why didn't you tell me right away? Why did, you know, you waited until I ate and until we had the intimacy, and now you're telling me? Next day he told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for them, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses their night, and they had a baby. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of their relationship at this night, Allah gave them a baby out of that. And subhanAllah, look at the fiqh and the understanding and the patience and the intelligence and the patience of sabr of this lady, and how she is, you know, this is an example for, subhanAllah, for us to have a peaceful marital life. How should we handle difficulties and circumstances? How should we patient with one another? How should we care for the emotions of one another? That's we learned that all from that story. They were also, subhanAllah, Abu Talha, like all the companions, loved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much so that one day he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he thought he's hungry. I need to invite him and offer him some food. Then he told Umm Sulaym. Umm Sulaym told him, you can go invite Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for some, you know, little amount of food, not a banquet. So he's talking about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and maybe a couple of other people with him. Just food that's enough for him and maybe a couple of other people. So he sent Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, Abu Sulaym, Abu Talha, sent Anas ibn Malik to invite Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was in the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is there any food involved? He said, yes. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited everybody in the masjid. They were around 70 people, 70 to 80 people. He invited them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He took him. He said, your brother Abu Talha is inviting you all to food. Let's go. They went to the house of Abu Talha. And you can imagine, a lady is cooking some food that's good for one or two people maybe, or a few people. And now, all of a sudden, 70 or 80 people are coming. But she knew, if that's, did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam know about that? Yes, if he knows about that, then he knows what he's doing. He came, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the house and told Umm Sulaym, you can start cooking, but when it is time for you to, specific process of the cooking, when it's time for you to do the bread, just call me. And she called on him, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blessed the food, and the food, subhanAllah, was enough to feed them all. When they cooked the food, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Talha started feeding them 10 by 10. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, get 10 people, and the 10 people would eat and go, because of the blessing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 10 more people, 10 after 10, 10 after 10, back to back, they are coming and they are all eating and enjoying a food that was supposedly to be enough for two or three people or a few people, but now it was sufficient for all of them because of the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it happened all because of Abu Sulaym and Umm Sulaym thought to invite Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah made this miracle to happen because of them. Abu Talha also defended Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very bravely in the battle of Uhud, and he was very good at archery. He was very good at archery. He was by the side of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and shooting at the enemies, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving him the arrows, and he is shooting, and he's saying, "Nahri duna nahrika ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, stay down, do not even raise your head. I am afraid that any harm could happen to you. May I be sacrificed for you. My neck is for your neck, ya Rasulullah. You stay there." And he was defending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very bravely in the battlefield, Abu Talha al-Ansari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He had so many other stories that shows his beautiful faith in Islam and his beautiful faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Abu Talha al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu, he lived for some time, for so long after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would fast, he would love fasting so much. According to some narrations, he was fasting almost every day, fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Radiyallahu tabarak wa ta'ala an Abi Talha al-Ansari, wa radiyallahu ta'ala an sahabati Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ajma'in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased and be happy with all the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah be pleased with Abu Talha al-Ansari, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with them all in al-Jannah. Allahumma ameen. I leave you in the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I see you next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.